prayer.
There is a need for prayer among God's people today.
Prayer leads to the proclamation of God's word
and the pouring out of revival.
The National Day of Prayer is a vital year-round movement,
rallying prayer for America.
As this movement has grown,
it has inspired,
encouraged,
and ignited many prayer movements across our nation
and around the world.
Every year, the first Thursday in May
is the National Day of Prayer.
From early morning to late night,
from the east to the west,
God's people, young and old,
will gather in prayer events across our nation
to cry out to God for America
and to pray God's glory across the earth.
Habakkuk 2:14 proclaims a promise
and a hope
to every generation.
Will you join us?
Will you tell others?
Will you pray?
Hello, I'm Tommy Floyd with First Baptist Church, Somerset, Kentucky. I'm glad that you could join us today because today is the National Day of Prayer. And just a word about prayer. Prayer allows us to reconnect minute by minute, hour by hour, day by day. It allows us, no matter where we are, to stop and connect with our Creator. What a wonderful thing. Just like in His Scripture, prayer offers us as Christians. But today, since it's the National Day of Prayer, our Southern Baptist Convention has produced a really neat tool for us to use in our prayer life. And I hope, since today is a special day of prayer, that you will check our website for the tool offered by Southern Baptist Convention. I know Sarah and the staff have placed that tool there for our use. So the SBC suggests that there are some things in our prayer life for the National Day of Prayer that we could think about and what we might pray about. And yes, we know that God already knows these things, but it's really important to remember that as Christians, we can ask God to take action into things that are on our hearts. So the SBC provides some things. We'll start off with our government. First of all, those folks that we elect and send to office who are willing, hopefully, to do things prayerfully, thoughtfully, we would pray that they would experience wisdom. Wisdom to think about all the repercussions of the decisions that they make. I think I would be remiss if I didn't hope that we would pray that our country would experience an awakening of faith, an awakening depending on God. Surely, in the COVID-19 season, we've seen where the virus doesn't mind what political party or church denomination, gender, race. The virus seems to be equal. We all need to ask for an awakening for our country. Up next would be our military. Those brave men and women out there who serve every single day, somewhere far from home, probably not as warm or as cool or as fed or as safe as we wish they were. But we need to pray for our military as they serve. A special prayer for the media arts. If you think about it, for the last several days, you've probably spent more time on your electronic device than any time in your life. Think about what comes through that electronic device. Not everything that comes your way is from God, godly, or positive. Let's pray that the people who are behind our media arts are providing some good, positive, uplifting influences that bring us as individuals and as a country back to our roots as Christians. Let's pray for the businesses. We all know that Kentucky and other states have experienced some economic shutdown. We've had businesses closed just due to safety. We've had the need to look at taking steps to keep folks safe, which meant that many businesses weren't operating. We've got a lot of people who are wringing their hands and praying very fervently. Let's join them. Let's pray for our businesses. Let's pray especially for our local businesses that have been closed. Let's pray for those people that are worried about how they're going to pay their bills. Let's pray nationally for the people who make things here in America. And let's choose those things. Education. Our schools have had a tough time. We've all thought about our seniors who didn't get to experience prom and graduation, the spring sports, all those things. We think about our universities who went virtual early, and then were joined by the rest of us. Let's pray for our teachers, administrators, and support staff. They must go back this fall, probably pre-vaccine, to a world where they've got to take special precautions to keep kids safe. I know it's probably something you already pray for, but let's remember our educators. Absolutely, let's pray for our church. Jesus and His work on earth carried out by individual churches. Of course, we need to pray for our church. We need to certainly pray for Brother Harmon and his family in the days to come with his new opportunity. We need to immediately pray for our church and our church staff that are here now. We need to pray for each one of the folks that are going to be carrying even more weight in this search process for the new pastor, new senior pastor. Let's not forget that maybe that's something we pray a little extra for our existing church. But let's remember that this is God's church. So as we pray for churches everywhere, let's remember that God will have a hand. He already knows who's going to be our next pastor because He's God. And so let's pray that we as a church body will have wisdom to be the kind of church, individual members to collective body, that our new pastor is going to be so tickled to experience. Let's also pray for our families. We've had a lot of people cooped up in small places over quite a long period of time. Our families probably need some prayer. We have some people who can't wait for things to reopen so they can get out and about. We also have a lot of people who've been alone. Let's pray for our shut-ins. Let's pray for those people who don't have a lot of company. And for all of you that you are who we're talking about, you haven't had a lot of company and you've really felt that aloneness. You're not alone. You know your Heavenly Father is with you, and you know your church is praying for you. So for all the FBC shut-ins and widows and widowers, I know the deacons are contacting some. We want you to know that we love you, we miss you, and we're praying for you. And then lastly, why not? Let's pray for the folks that are working to end this pandemic. Let's pray for the people on the front lines, in the hospitals, the doctor's offices, the clinics. Let's pray for our ambulances and our nurses and our policemen and firefighters who must be out there every single day, regardless of what it does to the potential for their personal safety. Let's pray for the researchers. Let's pray for those people who are trying to come up with a vaccine to stop the COVID-19. Our hope here at First Baptist Church is that you will consider using this tool today, especially on the day of prayer, to do two things. One, go down this list. You probably already have this list, but if not, it's a great tool to organize your thoughts. Think about praying for each one of these things collectively. Number two, ask yourself some really important questions. How often do I pray? Do I think there's things I can't say I'm sorry for? Because there's not. God wants to hear what's on our hearts. Things that we know we shouldn't do, but we need to talk to Him about. Things that are hurting our hearts, things that make us afraid, things that we're worried about for the future. The bottom line is, our God already knows what's on our heart, yet He asks us to approach Him in prayer. Jesus actually talked to His disciples about how to pray. And the Lord's Prayer is quite simple. So, on today, the National Day of Prayer, our hope here at First Baptist Church Somerset is that you find that quiet place and ask the Lord to intercede on behalf of many. We thank you. We love you. God bless you. And please enjoy today, the National Day of Prayer.
I bow my head to pray. I don't know what to say. I'm not sure how to fix the things I'm dealing with. I'm in a desperate place. I need to share the weight, but I just don't know how to let it all pour out. heart is crying, 'cause I was made to come to you. Place, Father, I know you can bear the weight. Father, take me in your arms as I speak your name. I lift my hands and pray.